our group is really engaged in understanding the relationship between molecular architecture and the interactions, the organization, and the properties of polymers in the solid state. We want to use this understanding in order to facilitate polymer materials that have novel properties that solve contemporary engineering problems, such as having polymers with enhanced thermal conductivity, with enhanced mechanical stiffness, or novel electronic properties. Breakthroughs in the ability to synthesize polymers that have occurred during the past 20 years, driven primarily by advances and discoveries made here at Carnegie Mellon University, have really transformed our ability to control the molecular structure of polymer chains away from simple linear chain structures that are the basis of the vast majority of materials we use today towards more complicated, very intricate architectures, star shapes, comb shapes, that feature a level of complexity that rivals molecules found in nature, such as DNA or polypeptides, proteins. One area that is of particular interest to us currently is the area of hybrid materials that comes about if we blend nanoparticles with polymer chains. One example is that we developed a process that allows us to control the shape of polymer chains on the surface of nanoparticles. And because the properties of polymers are very sensitive to the shape, this allows us to create hybrid materials with unprecedented property combinations. And we pursue these properties for applications in areas such as solid-state lighting, protective clothing, and flexible electronics. If we want to use more complex molecular architectures to engineer polymers with advanced properties, we will need tools that allow us to address materials in which there are many different variables that can change at a single time. This will involve the application of novel techniques such as machine learning, such as artificial intelligence. How we integrate these tools will be one of the challenges we have to solve. The second big challenge is that we want to realize these new properties that we can get through these new synthetic techniques without impacting the environment. In fact, if possible, reducing the impact that polymer materials have on the environment right now. And to facilitate this, more research will be needed and more advances will be needed to understand how we can design polymer molecules that will degrade in the environment, that are more amenable to a circular economy, so that we can avoid polluting in the first place.